match coming up today with Pistol Pez Wally.
I'm not worried about Pistol Pez Wally. I'm worried about the wildfire. The country boy can't survive. You know, we got a little bit of film here. It's got too far. It's got to the point. Well, one man can't be here no more. It's got to the point where it's got real heavy. Just show the film, Gordon Solie, and we'll show these people what heavy is. We'll show them what breathing is all about.
Well, of course, he's referring, of course, to a match that took place at the Omni when Tommy Wildfire Rich and Buzz Sawyer carried it beyond the confines of the squared circle. This is the situation that we are talking about. It has gone beyond. As you can see here, it has gone outside of the ring.
It's gone way deep. It's gone heavy. It's gone into the rafters. It's gone right into the middle of the street. It's gone all over the world. And Gordon Solie, it's time. The one man has got to go. One man can no longer go through this kind of punishment. One man can no longer. Look at him. He's a real animal, but I'm the mad dog. And the mad dog will prevail again.
And you're still here, and Murdoch is.
Look at the fight, Gordon Solie, all the way from the front of the Omni to the back of the Omni. You're gonna hear it because of that good man. I want this over with, Gordon Solie. I want it finished with. It's gone too far. It's gone too far for the Mad Dog. I told Dickie Murdoch, if you remember, Gordon. I told him, and nobody wanted to listen to me. Well, just wanted to listen, because the Mad Dog is around to stay.
Thank you very much.
Texas Deathmatch. The Mad Dog, Buzz Sawyer, clashes with Wildfire Tommy Rich. Falls don't count. Match continues till one man cannot answer the bell. Larry Zbysko, National Heavyweight Champion, clashes with Pistol Pez Whatley. The Road Warriors, National Tag Team Champions, managed by Precious Paul, against the Fantastic Ones, Terry Taylor and Bobby Fulton. TV title match, no time limit. The Iron Sheik against the one-man gang, Ronnie Garvin. If Garvin loses, he leaves town. Killer Brooks against Mr. Wrestling 2. Plus such other stars as Wild Bill Irwin, Chief Joe Lightfoot, King Carl Fergie, Arn Anderson, Norman Frederick Charles III, Rick Rude. That's Sunday the 17th, the Omni, Atlanta.
Also, let me tell you something.
How you doing, dog?
I'm doing good.
But
I'm
the Junkyard Dog, in case you didn't spot it.
I'm in Gator Country, beating up people. Here you is on Nationwide TV, Channel 17, our superstation with all those superstars. But no man, let's get this understanding, no man on any given day, anybody can be beat, Bez. But right here, you from Chattanooga, Tennessee, straight across the bridge from me. You helped me to get started, and here you is on here letting Buzz Sawyer beat you this great now, people. Here we ain't got no president, you ain't got no congressman, you ain't got this, you ain't got that, and here you stand out here with your head down, looking out at the ground. That ain't gonna get it, brother. You got to look up and start walking. And if that's what it's gonna take, I'm gonna wake up. Get mad at me, take it out on me, but get in that ring and show me, show your wife, show your kids what you can do, daddy, and it's gonna do it. Take that Buzz head off, take his head off, beat him up, that's what, beat him up. If you can't do it, baby, if you can't do it, pack your bags and quit the grade now, people, and leave this earth. But I know you can do it, Buzz. You got it, use the pistol, man, get in there, I'm gonna stay here, watch.
Oh, brother, I'll tell you what. And a Junkyard Dog means business, and we'll be back in just a moment. All right, Pistol Pez Whatley going up against Buzz Sawyer, and Whatley closes in on him. Sawyer, the kind of an athlete who doesn't care what happens to himself as long as he wins. He has no respect for his own body. He just wants to destroy. But, brother, he has got his hands full here. Whatley fired up after being slapped across the face and really psyched up by the Junkyard Dog, and Whatley is on top of him. And it is Whatley, another headbutt that puts Sawyer down. Sawyer dives in again, as I've said before. Sawyer does not worry about himself. He only wants one thing, and that's victory. The ultimate win. And that's what Pistol Pez Whatley is facing right now, is a man who just doesn't care. The only important thing to him is to get that hand raised in victory. But Sawyer's in trouble. Sawyer is rocking and reeling here. Sawyer retaliating, however. A power slam, but he didn't have it with it, that's for sure. Watley is down, however. Sawyer going up off that top. Watley moved to one side, and it is Sawyer in trouble again. Pistol Pez Watley. Caught him with a lariat coming off the ropes. Watley. Got the pin. Pistol Pez Watley has just done something nobody else has ever done here on World Championship Wrestling. He just pinned Buzz Sawyer. And Sawyer outside the ring cannot believe it. He absolutely cannot believe it.
I can't believe it. They talk about something can be done any time. I'll tell you right there, you just saw it. That's
Pistol. Amen to that. Pistol Pez Watley and brother. Here's that the Sheik found out that Ronnie Garvin's still very much after it.
You know, Gordon, there's such a thin line between sanity and insanity, and there's come a time when Precious Paul must sort of look back and say, hey, maybe there's a chance. Maybe there's a chance that something cannot be controlled.
We don't need you anymore.
Get out of here.
We're done with you.
We're the champions.
We don't need you.
We run ourselves.
Nobody
runs us.
Nobody.
So take a look and take a hike.
What happened here, Mr. Ellering?
I think there's a failure to communicate. Let me see here.
Failure to communicate? I think they communicated extremely well. I think Paul Ellering has just been fired. Wow! Ellering, who didn't quite believe what he had heard, stepped into the ring, and these Road Warriors are... Brother, you talk about vicious, bizarre individuals. Road Warriors closing in on Mike Starbuck and Chief Joe Lightfoot, the National Tag Team Champions. Ellering being assisted off the area, and brother, I'm telling you, I've got to say that I have watched a lot of men in professional wrestling over the years, but I have never seen anybody as completely vicious and as overwhelming as these two men, the Road Warriors, and they don't obviously, besides being tremendous athletes and superior physically, they have got or have developed a bent and twisted attitude. And Ellering, who thought he had everything going his way, has suddenly had his world come crashing down around him. These two men are just totally awesome.
You know, it's one thing to watch a guy like Pistol Pez Watley, and it's something entirely different. Twice I've been surprised today. Looking at what they just did to Paul Ellering just shows me one thing. They are truly without any feeling whatsoever. They're just after their own personal glory. The money, they're the most vicious team I've ever seen, and I've seen quite a few.
Coming from Ole Anderson, that is indeed...
You know, they've got such a high level of energy, apparently no disregard for themselves. They're not covering up. They're not even trying to be defensive. They're completely offensive in everything that they're doing. They're taking the attack. Look at that, a heck of a chop.
Starbuck moves into the ring, and the Road Warriors have him well under... Ooh! Hip lock takedown that has Starbuck back to the canvas once again. And you can see the intensity etched across their faces. As Ole Anderson said, as vicious a team as he's ever seen. And he's wrestled, I think, over the years, certainly every team of any prominence with total press over his head, 200 and some odd pounds well over his head, and catches him against Starbuck is just in... I don't see any chance for him at all.
You know, somebody asked me before, what was it like to be in a headlock with those guys? And I said, well, put your head in a vise in somebody's carpenter shop, and you may get an idea. Look at those arms. They're 22 inches, 23 inches, whatever they are. They're undoubtedly the biggest arms of... Come on, Lightfoot, that's it.
Lightfoot in there, but it might have been as well have been a mosquito. Taking a thing away from Lightfoot. I'm talking about the immense size, the tremendous conditioning of these road warriors.
They're monsters.
Count of three. It's over. It is over. And all I can say for Mike Starbuck and Chief Joe Lightfoot, mercifully, it is over. The road warriors, a cheap shot on the, as they started to...
Put down, baby. He's on the road warriors. We hold ourselves. No pressure, Paul. No, nobody runs us. This is us, Taylor, baby.
This is us, man. Y'all take a look, because we're walking death. We are walking death.
We are the road warriors.
Well, I think that they have made their point more than abundantly clear.
What do you think you're trying to do here, Bill, the Mad Dog? We're burning Tommy Rich, and then you hype him up, and then this brother of yours, the Deckard Dog, and the only dog around here. Who do you think you are? Coming out to this Wally, this Pez Wally, and getting him all jacked up. That was a fluke. That was a fluke. There's no way in the world man walking can beat the bad, mad dog. I want him again, Gordon. I want him again, Duncan. I want him now. I want him now.
Well, you may want him now, but right now we do have a match.
Here are you, junkyard dog. He's back to Jackson, Louisiana, or New Orleans or something. Let me see you come out and beat the mad dog again. I'm sick and tired of this.
Wait a minute. Buzz Sawyer going into the ring. This is, well.
Let me say something, Gordon, right now before Buzz beats the heck out of somebody. Somebody stole my heavyweight championship belt. Let me tell you something. People telling me it's Mr. Wrestling number two. Let me tell you something, Gordon. I'm going to get him. You know what they call that? They call that thief, Gordon. They call it a felony.
Now, I don't care if Wrestling Two got your belt or not. Right now, we've got Pistol Pez Watley and Buzz Sawyer in the ring again. The challenge of Buzz Sawyer, and it is Sawyer in there. Buzz, Pistol Pez Watley, and you can't tell which one. All right, Pistol Pez Watley back up another headbutt on Buzz Sawyer. Has Sawyer staggered again? Sawyer in trouble. As Pistol Pez Watley, and brother, you talk about somebody who is fired up. Pistol Pez is that indeed. Ooh, referee Scrappy McGowan jammed into that fire turnbuckle and is. Pistol Pez Watley hurtled over that top rope. And that's about 8 feet down to the concrete. And it is Buzz Sawyer has Pistol Pez Watley. And he tried to set him for a pile driver. Pistol Pez Watley reversed that situation. Sawyer in trouble. Pistol Pez Watley closing in on Buzz Sawyer once again outside on the concrete. A full body slam on Buzz Sawyer, and Watley moves in on him again. Buzz Sawyer continues to be in trouble. Ooh. He rammed him into that steel ring post. And look at the Sawyer, though. You got to give him... You got to say one thing about Sawyer. He doesn't care about himself, but he's locked again. Buzz Sawyer has just been defeated for a second time by a completely fired up, totally fired up Pistol Pez Watley. An unprecedented situation here on World Championship Wrestling. But I'll tell you what, Watley better be watching himself. Sawyer is indeed a mad dog, but right now he's a beaten mad dog. Well, the National Heavyweight Champ.
I'm here to find the belt, Gordon. I want the belt. It's my belt, and I